Okay, in this screencast, we're going to work through an example of using conversion factors in an engineering calculation. So we want to convert 5 newtons to something that's not very standard, just for some practice, to pound mass centimeter per minute squared. Just as a note, you all should know, or you should be able to look this up, that a newton is a kilogram meter per second squared. You should be familiar with converting between seconds and minutes and centimeters and meters. So we want to convert 5 newtons. So I like to put that on the left and over here on the right to what we're trying to convert to. So pound mass centimeters per minute squared. And I like to oftentimes set this up like this, where we're gonna put our different units on the top and bottom of this line. So we wanna cancel out newtons, right? And somehow get pound mass. Pound mass obviously is mass. Kilogram is mass. So we want to first convert newtons to kilogram meter second squared. All right. So this right here is equal to 1. All right. That's a conversion factor. So when we do that, so we know that there's 1 kilogram meter per second squared, a newton, 1 newton is 1 kilogram meter per second squared. So I'm going to write it like that. The newtons cancel. All right. So we've gotten rid of the newton. We need to somehow convert kilograms to pound mass. And so you guys should all know how to look up conversion factors between kilograms. So 1 kilogram is equal to about 2.20 pound mass. So I can cross out the kilograms, and now I've got that into pound mass on the top. So I need to get centimeters. I have meters on the top. So now what I need to do is I somehow need to have meters on the bottom and centimeters. So there are 100 centimeters in a meter, and I can cross that out. And now I've got pound mass centimeters on the top, which is what I want. And now I have seconds squared on the bottom, so I'm gonna actually do just 2 of the same here. I'm gonna convert seconds to minutes, and there are 60 seconds per 1 minute, and I'm gonna do that twice. So 60 seconds, 1 minute. So now I've got seconds in the numerator canceling with the 2 seconds in the denominator, and I've got my minutes squared in the bottom. So now it's just a matter of multiplying all the values, 5 times 2.2 times 100 times 60 times 60, and that will be the value that we're going to place here, and we've got the units in what we want. And when we do that, we get about 4.0 times 10 to the 6. That's in scientific notation. So we get 4 times 10 to the 6 pound mass centimeters per minute squared.